Did you know many Wendy's franchisees are making over $300,000? So if you're interested in potentially being a Wendy's owner, or if you're just curious about Wendy's as well as other quick service restaurants, this video is for you because we're going to dive in the numbers so you can see if a Wendy's franchise is at least worth exploring. So Wendy's is one of the most recognizable restaurant brands in the world. It is famous for hamburgers, sandwiches, fries, tenders, milkshakes, and they even incorporated breakfast in their menu offering not many years ago. Wendy's was founded in Columbus, Ohio by Dave Thomas in 1969. Thomas went on to serve as the chief executive until 1982. He wrote the book Franchising for Dummies. The family, even after his death in 1999, continued to own many franchises in the Wendy's system. In 2008, Arby's, the third largest restaurant chain at the time, purchased Wendy's for $2.34 billion. The brand would later separate and would completely cut ties in 2018. The 2020 net unit count went up by 29 locations, which isn't bad considering the COVID pandemic. And in 2021, it increased to 5,938 locations in the United States, with a net increase of 57 locations. Wendy's is well positioned in the food and beverage industry given its national brand recognition. Additionally, the royalties and marketing fees aren't that bad, with a royalty at 4%. That's under the average for royalties for food businesses at 5.3%. While other food franchises like Subway, Burger King, McDonald's permanently closed more restaurants in the United States in 2020 than they opened, Wendy's had a net increase in unit count, which is a very positive story if you're looking to get into the Wendy's franchise system. To get into a Wendy's, the costs vary across the board. There's a 10x difference from the low to the high point. $330K is the entry, and there's even special financing, especially for certain minority groups and certain neighborhoods if you're looking to get in under $330,000. But it can go anywhere up from $330,000 all the way up to over $3 million as disclosed in their 2020 franchise disclosure document. Now, you have a few different options. You can buy the land outright and build your own Wendy's, and that's going to be anywhere from about $2 to $3.7 million if you want to own the real estate, the building, as well as the restaurant operations. You can also finance the land, and this is going to cost you up to $1.1 million, or you could lease the location at up to $648,000. Now, Wendy's franchisees do really well. They're in a similar ballpark to McDonald's. The average Wendy's franchise restaurant is making $1.9 million in sales. Their corporate locations are doing even better at $2.1 million in sales with a 17.9% profit margin after paying rent. That's for their corporate locations. The median EBITDA, earnings before interest, taxes, depreciation, and amortization, is $380,000 for their corporate locations. So say you add in the royalties, because they don't disclose the EBITDA for their franchise locations, we estimate it's about $300,000 for a typical Wendy's location after incorporating the royalty payments and decreasing a little bit the average revenue, as there's a $200,000 difference between the corporate locations at $2.1 million and the franchise locations in annual revenue at $1.9 million. So Wendy's franchise owner salary and compensation is pretty high at about $300,000 a year. Franchisees can expect to recoup their initial investment anywhere from 1 to 10 years, really depending on how you finance a store. If you use leverage, if you're leasing the building, if you own the building, the payback period's really gonna vary based on what the financing of the operation was originally, as well as how you operate as an operator and where the location is. If you enjoyed this video, like us, follow us on YouTube, your favorite podcast channel, and email me at patrick@vettedbiz.com if you have any questions about other franchises besides Wendy's. Thanks.